The next bit we'd like to point to is another special work. We're very fortunate in this sort of band setting that we get to at times be acquire or steal repertoire from all sorts of mediums, whether it be rock bands, whether it be symphonic works, whether it be overtures, or other adaptations from other ensembles as well. This next work is basically different, no different. Camille Saint-Saëns was a very, very famous composer who composed operas, organ symphonies. Some of you might know the organ symphony from the movie Babe, Pig in the City. Have you seen that movie? Yeah. Your bomb, bomb, bomb. Yeah, that's one of Saint-Saëns' big pieces that he wrote. We're fortunate enough to play his marches there. Camille Saint-Saëns in his 50s spent a lot of time traveling the world, particularly in Egypt, Algiers. He actually passed away died in Algiers. But he had a sense of real, I suppose, nationalistic pride. We saw one of the garrisons there in Algiers with some French military musicians. And he thought, wow, I'm going to write a piece that portrays that. So this is actually the fourth movement of the M.L. work that he composed. And tonight, I thought it would be wonderful to broach that subject too. We have, and I'll get this down in just a minute, we have members of the 77th Army Band participating, helping out there of their own free will and their own free time this evening. Let's get these guys to stand up, please. We can break up.
Thank you.
we've taken you to a couple of places in the world already. We've taken you sort of to the UK. We've taken you to France, Algiers, Egypt, I suppose. We've probably brought you back to the States in a little way, I suppose, with that one. I'm going to take you back to Britain now and play a piece that was composed for a wonderful outfit, original revamp piece by Peter Grant called The Red Machine. Now, the piece, or the ensemble that was composed for, it's probably here, it's close to my heart, well, a little bit, it was sort of rival. So I was in the Central Ground of the Royal Air Force, and then in the Army they had the Coldstream Guards and the Grenadier Guards, which is sort of the equivalent to the Premier bands in DC, the President's Own, Pershing's Own, the Air Force Band, Navy Band, that sort of thing. But this piece was composed for the Coldstream Guards because their nickname basically is the Red Machine. And they called that for various reasons. Well, they're the guys you can honestly march up and down the square, down the mall, change the guard, up in the palace. They're doing it almost every second day. And not only are they doing that, I think in the same day they'll be off someone else playing for a dignitary or playing for a president from another country, prime minister from another country. So they're entitled to have it from a long time called the Red Machine. This is a wonderful work for me, man. It's our major work for this evening. We've worked extremely hard on this. This is, I suppose, in levels of difficulty. This would be a level 4 or 5, probably pushing closer to a level 6. We only need to get it a short amount of time, and we worked hard, didn't we, man? I told them they had to shake their heads. Really hard. We worked extremely hard. This showcases lots of things that a band is so great for. Not only marching down the square or playing for interviews, but playing serious repertoire for the media and the ear behind us. And it's a really, really great pleasure for me to present this work. It might be a premiere, certainly, in this part of the US as well. So it showcases great technique, showcases great dexterity from soloists, and we wish them all well, because they're going to do a great show. This is a Red Machine by Peter Grant. expectation that these faculty and my colleagues deal with that and give to these students is just amazing. And I do hope that you appreciate them as much as I do. I've got a little quiz here. I thought, what would be great? I want to give someone a gift here in Cameron. We don't yet have a band CD, but maybe we will sometime soon. But I thought we'd do a little bit of I've registered something out here. So I did a little bit of research and went on to the Australian Wikipedia. In fact, I tell my students, don't use Wikipedia. It's evil. First class I saw here, I showed a picture of a drop bear, and I'm like, oh, it's happening, it's got fangs and stuff. I said, that's a drop bear. I said, they attack Americans and British. I'm freaking out, I'm not going to show them. I said, I'm just joking. Someone made a page on Wikipedia, it's koala. It's not a koala bear, it's not a bear, it's a koala. But they just made up a page on Wikipedia of this drop bear. Just to fool people, just to show people, don't use Wikipedia in your citation. Students, okay?
Yes, not.
Okay, so I'll give you away a CD. This is one of my solo CDs. I thought I'd give away because you've been such an awesome audience tonight. And my question is this, and all I'll do is look at it in the yonder and see who the first person is. But you have to get this right. Who was the 45th president? Well, I want to thank you for coming this evening. This is with Trumpets and Drums.